So I actually came here first in 1980, but I came as a visiting postdoc doing some research in the basic science building. And I was impressed with what I saw. So when I looked for my first faculty position, I came back here in 1982. But back at the time I came in 80, I stayed in the student housing on the other side of 5, and there was a bumper sticker that said, is there life east of 5? Most proud of in order would be, first, I helped to bring the Journal of Clinical Investigation here for the 5-year stint. The second was my research is in the area of studying glycosylation, the sugars that are on the surface of cells. And I've created, along with Jeff Esco and others, a glycobiology research and training center here that's internationally recognized. And the third and final thing is a clue. It turned out that humans and chimpanzees, our closest evolutionary relatives, are different in molecular ways. And in the 1990s, we happened to find the first known example of such a difference. And so that led me to lead into a field which is now called anthropogeny, that is the study of the origin of humans. Yeah, so in most major academic institutions of this caliber, they've been around for a very long time. And they were started in the traditional way of the traditional departments and so on. There's a hierarchy. And UC San Diego, as you know, was started in a very unusual way, especially the School of Medicine, without basic science departments and the idea that we could collaborate across campus and do that. And some of that has changed, but because of that unusual way of starting the place, all possibilities are wide open. You can do things at UC San Diego you can't do anywhere else.